Hey, new city kids.
Hey, juniors and all-stars. We're so excited that you're here today. My name is Kenzie.
My name is Alyssa. And today we're gonna start with some stretching. So wherever you are, stand up, make sure you have some space around. We're gonna be moving. Okay, so we're gonna start with putting your right arm across your body and stretching. Stretch. Okay, take your left arm and stretch it across your body and go stretch. Good job, Kenzie.
Thanks, Alyssa.
Okay, now I want you to reach all the way up to the sky. Stand on your tippy toes. Stretch. And now touch your toes. Oh, big stretch. Awesome, and then just shake it out.
Shake.
Awesome, thanks so much, juniors and all-stars.
Great job. All right, let's go to our new city kids values.
Hey, new city kids, guess what time it is? It's time for our new city kids values. And here at New City Kids, we have five of them. Our first value is love God. We love God because He first loved us. And our second value is love people. We love people because God loves all people. And our third value is do your best. Why? Because when we do our best, God does the rest. And our fourth value is be generous. When we're generous, we have helping hands. And last but not least, our fifth value is choose joy. When we choose joy, that means we can always have a positive attitude. And that's it for our New City Kids values. Now it's time to worship together.
Required for life and godly
It's memory verse time.
All right, juniors and all-stars, today we have a memory verse, but we're gonna do something exciting. Today, we have motions to go along with it.
I'm so excited.
I'm so excited too. All right, you guys know the drill. The first time, I'll say the memory verse, and Alyssa's gonna show us motions. And then the next time, we'll all do it together. All right. His divine power has given us everything that's required for life and godliness. 2 Peter 1:3. All right, let's do it again. His divine power has given us everything required for life and godliness. 2 Peter 1:3.
Great job, juniors and all-stars, and you can keep practicing this at home.
Peter was one of Jesus' disciples who became a leader in the early church. He wrote two letters in the Bible to help believers who were facing hard times. When Peter wrote his second letter, he was in a Roman prison. He had been arrested because he was a follower of Jesus.
Peter wrote, "We have everything we need because we know Jesus. When we trust in his righteousness, he gives us power to live for him. He is good, and he promises us good things. So this is how we should seek to live. Along with faith, seek these things: goodness, knowledge, self-control, patience, brotherly affection, and love. When we have these qualities, Jesus will be glorified in our lives. When we remember the good promises God has for us, we can rely on his power to resist temptation."
Peter wanted the believers to remember what Jesus had done for them. Jesus did the greatest work by dying on the cross. He has taken away our sins. Because of Jesus, God invites us into his kingdom and gives us eternal life. Peter wrote, "God has chosen you and given you his power, so do everything you can to live like Jesus."
Peter knew he was going to die soon. So he also wrote, "You already know what I'm telling you. I want to keep reminding you as long as I am living, so that you will remember even after I'm gone. We did not tell you made-up stories. We told you what we saw and heard."
Jesus lived a perfect life and died the death we deserve for our sin. When we trust in Jesus, God forgives our sins and changes our hearts. Jesus calls and empowers his followers to live like him.
Thank you so much for watching with us. This week, we learned that life was hard for Jesus's followers.
That's right. But Peter wanted believers to remember what Jesus had done for them.
That's right. Okay, now let's review our story point from today's lesson. Our story point today is Peter encouraged believers to live like Jesus.
Yes, and our big picture question asks, how does the Holy Spirit help Christians? The Holy Spirit comforts us, shows us our sin, and guides us as we live for God's glory.
That's right. Okay, so now we're gonna close in prayer.
All right, let's fold our hands and bow our heads. Dear God, thank you for making us more like Jesus every day. Give us humble hearts that want to obey you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, New City Kids, for joining us this week. We will see you next week. But until then, always remember that
Jesus loves you, and so do we.
Bye.